Hi guys, today I'm going to show you how to use Seesaw to solve systems of equations with graphing. So you've been working on it for a couple of days now, and today you're going to try to graph your own equations and find the solution. So remember, the solution to a system of equations is the point where your two lines intersect, right where they cross each other, okay? And the solution is going to be written as an ordered pair, okay, as a coordinate, an x coordinate and a y coordinate. So let's take a look at our first system of equations. So the first equation is y equals negative 1/2 x plus 2. So for this, first I'm going to choose the highlighter tool here at the bottom. I'm going to click on it. I want to make sure that the size is this, the second largest one. And you can use any color you like. I'm going to use, let's say blue for this one. Okay, light blue. So I'm using highlighter and pick any color you want as long as the size is this size right here. Okay, this one will probably be a little too small. The next one's probably a little too big. All right, so y equals negative 1/2 x plus 2. The first point that you graph when you are graphing linear equations in slope-intercept form is the y-intercept. The y-intercept is the constant, okay? The constant in this first equation is plus 2, okay? That means that positive 2 on the y-axis is our y-intercept for that first line there. From the y-intercept, I'm going to use the slope as a set of directions to get a second point, and sometimes even a third if you can. Since the slope is the number in front of the x, the slope is negative 1/2. Okay, so I'm from the y-intercept, that means I'm going to go down 1, because it's negative 1, and right 2, and I'm going to put my point right there. Since I have room here on the graph, I'm going to make a third point, okay? The slope is a constant, it doesn't change, so I'm going to go down 1 and right 2 again and put a third point. So once you have at least 3 points here, okay, make sure you have your highlighter tool, make sure you have second biggest point here. You're going to try to draw a straight line, if you can, through your 3 points. And you want to try to make it go through as much of the graph as you can. It's a little tricky in Seesaw to keep your lines perfectly straight, but do the best you can. Okay, you can see there, my line's not that straight. Now, if you can, you can even go ahead and add the arrow there on the end of your line, because remember, linear equations are infinite. Okay, so really, it doesn't just stop here where our graph ends. It would keep going in both directions. All right, so that's our first line. Y equals negative 1/2 x plus 2. Let's take a look at our second equation, y equals 1/2 x. Now, there's no constant here. Does that mean we don't have a y-intercept? No, just means that the y-intercept is actually 0. I'm going to just use the pencil tool for a minute. Okay, so really they could have written y equals 1/2 x plus 0, but when you simplify that, the plus 0 really would go away. Okay, so they don't write that. If you don't see a constant when your equation's in slope-intercept form, your y-intercept is 0. I'm going to select my highlighter tool again, make sure I have the right size. And since the y-intercept is 0 for my second equation, that's at the origin, I'll put a point right there. It's a little hard to see. Then I'm going to use the slope to find a second and hopefully a third point. The slope is the number in front of the x, so the slope is 1/2. So that means, since they're both positive, I'm going to go up 1 and right 2 and put a point right there. Since I still have room, I'm going to do a third point, up 1, right 2. Okay, once you have 3 points there, go ahead and draw your line through the 3 points as straight as you can. Okay, and then what we're looking for is the place on the graph where the two lines intersect. Now, try to make this easier for you guys. This activity is called whack-a-mole. So the answer, the solution to your system of your equations is always going to be the point where one of the moles is, okay? So I can see that it crosses through this mole right here, the intersection, the place where the two lines cross, and I have to identify that coordinate, okay? So that coordinate is right 2 up 1, so the solution is 2 comma 1. So you're going to select the label tool, the T, okay? Your text box pops up right here. I'm going to write 2 comma 1, okay? Then you're going to make sure you have the move tool selected down here at the bottom. Okay, you can make it a little bit smaller and then drag it over there to the solution for the first system of equations. So the solution is the ordered pair, the place on the graph where the two lines intersect. So go ahead and complete the rest of the graphs on this first slide and on the second slide. Reach out if you have any questions. Good luck. Have fun.